Hello, I'm Dr. Nick Delgado, and I'm excited to interview Dan Holtz. It's a very interesting phenomenon when people develop skin conditions. Acne is a rather emotional, challenging, and physical because it's so apparent. But there's a controversy, and some people found it hard to believe that estrogen or estrogen dominance had anything to do with acne. Everyone always blamed androgens and testosterone. Share the story. That's fascinating what you were sharing with me earlier.
Well, Nick, at Beverly Hills Rejuvenation Center, one of the things that we see a lot is women ages generally 35 to 45 especially that experience estrogen dominance due to progesterone deficiency. Progesterone deficiency can be caused by many reasons, one of which thyroid function goes down, production of various sex hormones goes down. When progesterone levels decline, and in most females 35 to 45, you'll see levels drop anywhere from 40 to 50% from what they were at age 20. So when progesterone levels decline, estrogen levels actually increase. So estrogen dominance becomes much more of a problem. And for a long time, I did believe that androgenic hormones were the only cause of acne, but it became very clear to me as our center started treating more and more females for acne problems, it became very crystal clear that estrogen had a great role in production of excess oil production, and there's no question that as you get closer to menstruation, that if that progesterone level
that
was
day
low,
cycle between
day 13 and 27, usually by, depending on how much progesterone is made, the closer that they'd get to menstruation, that estrogen had much more of an influence on oil production. So by getting the progesterone levels back to a youthful range, which ultimately meant supplemental progesterone, we were able to calm acne problems. We're at a point now where we solve almost every case that comes our way, and it's always by treating estrogen, estrogen dominance. It's rarely anything but that, quite frankly.
Amazing. And there's probably an interplay between excess estradiol, excess 16-alpha-hydroxyestrone, and many doctors, I'm sure you'd agree, rarely check the urinary metabolites for hormones, which oftentimes can exert as much or more estrogen dominance than the primary estradiol, estriol, and estrone. Let's address that. Do you look at 24 urines at times?
I tell you what, we don't. And the reason we don't is because when we do a lot of our testing, the PPO insurance plans cover,
they don't
blood
cover.
Tests. So for us, and people complain, they don't want to walk around with a urine jug all day. And so urine, although absolutely that's how you really get accurate, but for us, it's almost like we just know when women are 35, they're going to be at a point where progesterone deficiency is almost a guarantee. So we just know, that when we see that estrogen dominance in the in the blood work, we ultimately realize that very quickly by getting progesterone levels back to optimal, we're going to get that problem solved. So we're able to solve it without having to go to that extent of testing.
Dan Holtz, if we looked at this, some of our younger viewers, say, age 13 to 21, they're just developing their cycles, or their cycles are coming to full force. With them, not only might they still have a progesterone deficiency only because of the estrogen dominance, it's so much higher. Estrogen is a very potent hormone, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, in that case, usually the problem would be excess estrogen, not necessarily progesterone deficiency.
Right.
So in reality, sugars, sweets and high glycemic foods and things like that, and stress, of course, all driving excess estrogen. So when you think about the hormone, if you think about adrenaline, so you can actually make a female, if you oversupply her thyroid, if you're treating a thyroid deficiency and you oversupply her thyroid, her estradiol level will skyrocket. Same way, if she's exposed to a lot of adrenaline, that same overstimulation of the ovaries is going to make estrogen levels go way up. So you might take a 20-year-old girl who's perfectly capable of making a progesterone level of 18 to 20 on a blood test, which is considered to be adequate, but if her estradiol level goes to 200, which is twice normal or roughly twice normal, she's still going to have estrogen dominance, acne, all the same problems as if she had low progesterone.